morning.
So good to see you here. I have a story about this little puppy. His name is Millet. He's a little dachshund. And he belongs to a family. Their last name is Adams. Is this one?
Yes.
Well, Mrs. Adams was getting ready to go to a shower. You know the showers? Party, and somebody's going to have a baby and they bring gifts, or somebody's getting married and they bring gifts. Well, she was going to go to a shower and she was wrapping the gift. But she needed the scissors. She had to have the scissors to cut the paper. But she couldn't find them. She's looking here and she's looking there all around the house. She calls out to her husband, "Do you know where the scissors are?" He's busy paying bills. "No, I don't know where they are." Well, there was two girls in the family. Abby was 6, Allison was 4. Yes. Oh, do you? Okay. So, all over the house are the scissors, and I can't find them. I gotta have the scissors. I gotta be leaving in about 15 minutes to get to the shower. So, I know. I think maybe they're in the pantry. You know what a pantry is? It's a closet where they keep food. I think I might have left them in the pantry because I cut the bag of food open for Miller, their dog. And maybe I left them in the pantry. So she went to the pantry. She opened the door. The first thing she saw was not the scissors. What she saw was a big clump of blonde hair hanging over the wastebasket. No answer. "Where are you, Allison?" No answer. They looked all around the house. They finally knocked on the laundry room door because that was the room where Miller stayed most of the time because that's where his dog dish was with his water and his food. And she pushed the door open to the laundry room just a little bit and she saw this little nose stick out. "Allison, come out here." Oh, she came out. Guess what? No ponytail. No hair up here by her forehead. She cut it off right up to her skin. "Allison, what happened?" What'd she say? "Miller did it." Miller, the little puppy, cut her hair?
No.
No. Was she telling a lie?
Yes.
Yes. She came out of the laundry room with her head down. "Oh, I'm so sorry, Mommy. Please forgive me." And then Mommy's thinking, I forgive you, Allison. And then she's thinking, what are we going to do? In 2 days, Allison was supposed to have her picture taken for school.
Oh, my
goodness. Mommy's thinking, what hat are we going to put on her to have her picture taken? Well, you know, she said, "Allison, you know you did 2 things wrong. First of all, you went against Mommy and Daddy. You didn't obey because you're not supposed to have those big scissors. Number 2, what else did she do?" She told a lie and she blamed her haircut on Miller. Well, she asked Mommy and Daddy to forgive her. And Mommy said, "I forgive you. But you know what? When we do something wrong like that, we also ask someone else to forgive us, don't we?" Who? Jesus. And God does forgive us, doesn't he? Also because he loves us to the point that he allowed his only son to die for us. Isn't he a wonderful God? So thankful that we have a wonderful God we can serve because he loves us and we love him. Would someone like to pray?